This is Rakesh from Let's Make Learning Simple channel. Now we are going to discuss about adaptive design pattern in theoretical using some real life examples and real time technical examples. In the next video, we'll try to cover how to write a simple program for implementing adaptive design pattern using Java. So first, what is adaptive design pattern? So if you think about adapter, you would have come across this name in your life in many times. So you would have intentionally known about this, or sometimes you have unintentionally, you would have used the adapter for solving your real-time problems. So we'll try to cover those problems using real-life examples. So the definition between the, it falls under structural design pattern. So there are three types of design pattern. It falls under structural design pattern. You would get the idea why it falls under structural design pattern when we actually implement a simple program for adaptive design pattern. So that would be covered in the next video. Please try to watch that video also. It acts as bridge between two incompatible interfaces. So for example, we will try to cover this using real life examples. Suppose if you are using MacBook Pro means, so what you would do, what you would have observed is there wouldn't be any USB ports at all. So there would be only USB-C port. So this is the USB-C port and these are USB port. If suppose if you want to connect this USB port to our MacBook Pro means, what you need to do is you need to buy this adapter. This will convert this USB to USB-C. So what we need to do, we need to just insert this in the adapter port and it will convert this USB to USB-C. So this is one of the important examples. And the next example is memory card reader. If suppose if you are using any laptop or PC means, at most of the laptops and PC, there won't be any memory card reader inbuilt. So what you do is you will try to get a memory card reader for that and you will try to insert your memory card in that and you will try to connect in the USB port. So this is one of the adapters. And then is the phone adapter. If suppose if you are trying to charge your phone, means what you do is you will try to insert the pin into a phone and you will try to put the adapter in this socket. That adapter, what it do is it will try to convert the 220 volts. So basically in India, 220 volt is the power that we are getting for household purposes. So it will convert the 220 volt to 9 volt for phone applications, for phone usage. So this is the real time, real life example. These are the real life examples. We'll try to cover the technical real time examples. If suppose if you are using if suppose you are writing any Java application and that Java application needs to connect with the database, means for the people who write in Java, they don't aware about the database that is behind. For example, it can be Oracle or it can be MySQL or it can be Sysbase. Based on time, the database may convert to the advanced databases. For example, so if suppose if a new vendor is providing a better database, means the people behind that would change that that actual database thing. So we don't aware about the database that began running. You just need to write an application using some command, some statements, some MySQL, some SQL statements. That adapter class would handle those problems, that handle those things. For example, if suppose if you are trying to migrate from Oracle to Sysbase, means that adapter class will be changed. So this would be handled by this adapter class. So this is the real-time technical example. We will try to cover the implementation in the upcoming video. Please try to subscribe my channel for watching further videos also.